Welcome to HDTV. You're now rocking with your boy. That was the most boringest game I've ever seen. And the Texans had a chance to win. My thing is this. You have nothing to lose. You are in a dogfight with an undefeated team, a fraudulent offense, a fraudulent 2-0 team, which we saw tonight. And that's why I kept saying. But shout out to Christian for his team winning. You know, his team, they pulled it off at the end. To me, it was more of the Texans losing than the Panthers actually winning. The Panthers, this is what my thing. Darnold overthrew a couple receivers where they could have got in position to blow. They should have won by 2 touchdowns. When the Texans made it a dogfight, Culley had a 4th and 2 or 4th and 1. I don't know. I was so mad. This idiot here. Hold on. Give me a second. Because I'm finna go off on this idiot. Now I see why Deshaun don't want to play. I'ma tell you why, because I'm pissed off. And this is why the Texans deserve to lose that game. Okay, I'm good. I had to put my loafers on. I keep me some loafers in the car after I done did a hard day work so my feet will feel better. That's how you take care of your feet. You put your loafers on, your house shoes is what we call loafers. If people don't know what the hell that means, they like, HD, what the hell is you talking about with loafers? Loafers, man, your house shoes. You put them on after a hard day work so you can preserve your feet. You gotta take care of your feet when you're in the line of work that I'm in. You gotta wear the right gear to keep yourself good. And I'm gonna start going back to the gym soon. I'm gonna record some of that stuff of me working out, getting my fat butt back in shape. I'm getting older, so I gotta take care of myself and I gotta add to my regimen. Now, I'm finna go off on David Culley. I'm past the 2-minute mark. This sumbitch, like an old redneck from the South would say. This sumbitch right here, he had a chance to go for it on, I think it was a 4th and 2, 4th and 1. If he would have got the first down, they could have put pressure. They were moving the ball. Then he went too conservative. He should have let the kid do some more play actions, throw the ball some, let him throw some quick passes, then go deep. He didn't even try to go deep once. You always try to go deep to test the defense, to see what the defense is doing. And that's what pissed me off about these goddamn coaches. These coaches today do not know how to coach. It's like they got stuck or they're not allowed to. Then it's like this. If you're running the cover two, Lovey, why aren't you having your corners press DJ Moore or Anderson? You guys are giving them a free release. No wonder they... Dog, DJ Moore was killing you guys because y'all kept giving this guy a free damn release. Y'all kept giving him a free damn release down the goddamn field. It's like, oh my gosh, dog, this dude is an idiot. Where did you learn how to coach? Then on offensively, you could have ran the ball, got the first down, or did a play action. At least go for it. You gonna take a penalty and get out of the chance to try to kick a field goal, which they were like, I think it was 56, 55 yards or something. You should have gone for the ball. You should have gone for the play right then and there. They just lost their best corner in J.C. Horn. I hope J.C. Horn is okay. The Panthers' front seven was okay tonight. I felt they should have blitzed a little more, but they did blitz a lot. And Burns, Christian, you are right. Burns is the best player on your defense. So is Shaq Thompson. Shaq Thompson is right there with him. Shaq Thompson was everywhere. Him and Burns were just crushing them. So the front seven, I gave a B minus. I gave the front seven an A plus. The secondary, the defense, I say the defense was great. But to me, it was more about the Texans not capitalizing than the defense actually doing what they're supposed to do. That's just how I look at it. But this game was, to me, this game was a D minus. It was horrible. Defensively, it was good. But to me, it was more about the ineptitude of both offenses. Sam Darnold lucked up tonight because the Texans let him off the hook. But a few times, Sam Darnold looked terrible. Like, to me, overall, Sam Darnold played a terrible game. Now, he did get some plays off. He did make some throws, which was okay, cool. But to me, they should have won by two or three touchdowns in the beginning. Joe Brady to me is an overrated offensive coordinator. Teddy Bridgewater is correct. He's not that good. And I see why. Darnold made some plays running and everything. Like I said, Darnold was a front runner tonight. We'll see down the line how he plays against a tougher defense and tougher opponents. And I think the second time they're going to play the Saints going to get in their ass because the Saints are going to have all their people. Hopefully they have all their coaches. They got hit by the COVID bad. So we'll see. We'll see what's up, but the game I gave a D minus to. To me, it was just about bad offenses. The defenses, they're good. I mean, the Panthers defense, to me, they're good and all, but I mean, we'll see. I want to see them against a great offense and see what happens. But they're legit. I mess with them, but Sam Darnold and the coaching staff, I do not trust neither one. I think both are overrated. So, you know, we'll see what's up. Now, should the Bucs be worried? Hell no. The Bucs should beat them by two touchdowns when they play. Now, Burns off the edge, I believe Worlds can hold him down, the left tackle. Shaq Thompson, he'll be a problem. Like I said, they'll do some things, but Tom Brady will get the ball out. Now, J.C. Horn, that injury, we got to see what happens. He might be back. You know, we'll see. We got to see what happens. Excuse me. We got to see what happens with him. But I like the Panthers' defense. I think the Panthers' defense is going to give us trouble. But I think eventually we'll figure it out and we'll beat them. I still think the Saints could come back and split with them. I still got the Saints making the playoffs. It's nothing against the Panthers. I just don't trust the Panthers' offense. Now, if Sam Darnold plays like Trent Dilfer did that year for the Ravens, hey, something could happen. But the Panthers got a good defense, but it's not Ravens defense great. But it's good, though. They're pretty good. Like I said, I gave their defense B-, C-plus. I felt like they miscued on some plays, but that's due to losing their corners and losing certain people. So they can capitalize. They can come back off of that. Now, offensively, man, they're F. To me, they're F. They're DJ Moore or bust. If DJ Moore, you know, isn't out there producing or getting open, then you got the other guy, Arnold, the guy Cumbie or Cumber, whatever his name is, the running back came in. He was pretty good. CMC, could they do better? We'll see. We'll see what happens. But they were struggling to blow a team out that they should have blew out. Carolina should have blew this team out. And when the Texans was in a dogfight with them, the Texans should have at least won by 3 points or four. They could have stole this game. But Culley, the head coach for the Texans, played too conservative. He played real too conservative. He should have went for the kill. But he nutted up, like always, like all these other coaches do. But we'll see. The Saints, I still think the Saints could beat them. I think the Saints, just when they get all their people back, they'll be fine. You know, Christian was trying to say, well, they still could have played. And I'm like, Christian, no, they couldn't have. You got to understand, football is not like basketball. You can miss a few coaches in basketball, you'll still be fine because you have a superstar out there and you have players. And that's facts. So, you know. We'll see, man. We'll see. But the Panthers, they are better than last year. But I still don't trust their offense. I still think their offense is very inept. Now without Chris McCaffrey, we'll see how good they'll be. So, yeah. Now, word has it is that the LA LeBrownies, everybody is going to be vaccinated. They're saying that vaccination, the whole team will be vaccinated this year. And the reason they're saying that is because last year, LeBrownies did not take the vaccine. But they were getting on other guys and other players to take the vaccine. So the Lakers basically trying to say they're going to be vaccinated because the commissioner and them are tired of the backlash on LeBrownies. And look, man, LeBrownies better win this damn championship this year. I'm tired of hearing you fucking LeBrownie fans cry like, man, he ain't no great. He's a bum. He's a great talent. He's a terrible player. As a talent, he's a B-. As a player, he is an F. All right? He has no skill. And stop. Don't show me no replay of him on the post doing a spin move and getting a dunk. Wow. He looks like he's about to kill himself every time he tries to move. He has terrible footwork. And people actually say he's great. Must be idiots. So like I said, we'll see. Now, Kyrie Irving might not be able to play. He might miss half of the year because he's not taking the vaccine and he's adamant about not taking it. And look, just because he don't want to take it, I'm not trading him for no goddamn Ben Simmons. Ben Simmons is trash, all right? He has no heart. He's soft. He's easily rattled. I could play this guy. This guy here could play and not be rattled. So they're basically saying he could not, that he might not be able to play in some games where they might, where you have to be vaccinated to play. So we'll see how long this lasts. But it is what it is. That's how Kyrie feels. To me, he was wrongfully fined last year. What they should have done was fine that big bum, but they're not going to do it because he's the so-called face of the league. So we'll see with that. That's all I have on the game. I gave the game a D-. Like I said, I broke down the points of why. The Panthers do not look good. I do not see them. I still do not see them making the playoffs. We'll see. They could if they clean up some things, but I still have the Saints beating them out for that. So we'll see. Thank you for listening. Like, comment, subscribe, share this. Hit the notification bell to select all to receive upcoming notifications. And if you love what you hear, you can donate to the page by cash apping me at the word welcome, the number 2, and then HDIITV. Thank you for listening, and we out. Deezy.